What does the tree symbolize? Very simply, it symbolizes the spirit of Southwestern, the spirit of being a student here, the spirit of working here, the spirit of experience what it's like to be a member of this school community, and the importance of the Mustang as a symbol of the energy, the class, the dignity of what we're looking to achieve, of always being the best that we can possibly be in everything that we do, and of having that very, very classic look of being always a part of that spirit of that mascot that was selected by the early classes, that this will be the symbol of the spirit of Southwestern. The original Mustang was selected because at that time Southwestern was a brand new school. And at that time, as they were looking at, you know, what would our mascot be, they selected the Mustang because the Mustang was from the southwestern part of the United States, and it was young, untested, and free. And that's what we were in 1959, 60, 61. We were a brand new school district, young, we were untested, and we were free to chart our own course for the rest of the history. And I guess the rest is sort of history. The Mustang has become a strong symbol, so strong that even after 40 plus years of existence of the school district, our desire to keep that symbol alive is still burning very deeply in all of our hearts. My hat goes off to every alumni that has gone to Southwestern, to the current student body who has taken this project upon themselves so that that spirit could be reserved for all generations to come.
Back in 1985, it was really cold winter and the tree had been cut down to pretty much a stump. There wasn't anything left, about 25 foot tall. It was still getting painted, but there was a rumor going around school that it was going to be completely cut down because it was a hazard. And a bunch of students, including myself on the student council, decided we didn't want that. I actually came up with the idea of a carving for it based off of some ice sculptures and stuff I saw and sitting in people's yards, and spent about a month looking around until I found some people. Eventually, Steel Chainsaw is one of the contacts I made through a local hardware store, and they led me to Mr. Dennis Beach, who lives up near Berwick, Pennsylvania.
Oh, and when I started, I didn't know how to draw. And I didn't even bring a picture of a horse to go by, other than a horse in that position rearing up. So I had Tim drew the horse on the side. You see this Mustang every day you go to school. I said, you should be able to draw it on. So he drew like a big slice off the side of the tree. He drew the Mustang on, and I started carving.
The Mustang horse, the first discussions we had about the possible replacement probably go back about 5 years ago, when there was a growing concern about the deteriorating structure of the horse as we saw some rotting spots start to take place in the horse. There are preliminary discussions that took place at that time, but we never really got very far because there wasn't a sense of necessary urgency at that point in time. We felt that we had several years instead to make the decision, and so we never really got into all of the details that would go into replacing the Mustang tree. Of course, this year's tornado, when it hit in September, changed an awful lot of that and heightened the urgency with regard to the replacement effort. And student liaison, which represents all of the classes with in the school and major organizations, was the perfect organization and perfect student group in order to start the discussions and then try to put together a plan for the replacement of the tree.
This year, the 2001-2002 student liaison has taken on a tremendous task of replacing the Mustang tree. This Mustang tree has been a symbol of our school and community for quite some time now, and the decision has been made because of the deterioration of the tree and the state that it's in. It might not last too much longer, and we decided that it's time to replace it.
Student liaison is the main organization involved, but there is some help from the senior class officers, who the senior class's gift is going to be the restoration of the tree that's out there now. Also, the Alumni Association is very active in replacing the tree. Administration has been great We've received support from Mr. Tim Oster and his father, who have given many donations towards this project. Also, Mr. Keith D. Smith was important because he has donated the cement and the time and the manpower to build the tree. The first step involved in making this horse was that the carver for the original horse was contacted to see if he could be interested in doing this again. He said yes. And then Mr. Oster was in charge of many of the details, such as getting a crane to lift, buying the wood, supplying any materials that Mr. Beach, the carver, needed. From then, we were in contact with Mr. Smith, who was in charge of supplying the base. And I would say that it was probably about 4 or 5 months of actual planning involved. We had to plan things as minor as what color to paint the horse, to things as extreme as what shape to make the base, how big we wanted the horse. So it was probably about 4 or 5 months of preparation involved.
The materials being used for the replacement of the tree, first of all, the actual horse has been donated by Mr. Tim Oster, and it was carved by Mr. Beach, who was the original carver of the first tree. And the actual concrete is being done by Keith Smith Concrete Company, and he is donating the labor for that part of the project. The original timeline, we wanted to start on April 1st with the concrete base and be finished by Memorial Day. And the project actually got started the second week of April, and we're hoping to be finished the week of May 20th.
So when I found out the students were trying to get this one done and try to restore the old one, I knew I had to be a part of it. The tree means a whole heck of a lot to me, and that's why I wanted to be there when the new one went up. And that's why I wanted to ensure that at least part of it was made out of wood, because that's what the original tree symbolized, and it had to carry over to the new one.
Stop me.
And as you can see, here it stands, ready to go another 15, 20 years. As far as fond memories I have, probably painting with my friends right after I came back from our senior class trip, knowing probably the last time I'd see some of these people for a long time. I haven't seen some of them since, but I can still remember that night probably like it was yesterday. A lot of fun, a lot of memories that hold on to, and that's what this tree's supposed to be about. Not just about the message that are on it, but the friendships that are bond when you do it. So if you ask me, that's what's the most important part of this whole project is, keeping students together, keeping community together, and there's not much more of that that I can really say about it.
The Mustang tree was probably when it was painted after the death of Mr. Phil Hensing. Although I was only in eighth grade at the time, I still felt it was very fitting and very appropriate because Mr. Hensing was symbolic of a true Mustang. And, you know, I thought that it was just appropriate after his death to paint a tree to honor him. I thought it was just a great project.